Now let's talk about the process of you putting together the songs for this record for Keep On Loving You, because you apparently have a very great ear for finding things, and I'm sure you get lots of stuff coming to you. How do you find the good stuff?
8 months before we go in to record, I let all the songwriters and publishers know that we're going to record, like say in January, like we did for this album. And so they start sending in demo tapes and CDs. And so I listen to it. My folks at Starstruck over at Valerie Music Company, they start listening. My friends listen for me, and we're all looking for that great monster song. And that's what's so hard, because everybody else in the business is looking for that monster song. So everybody's in there looking and really fighting for those great songs. And at one time, I had 200 songs on hold. So then I got them down to 15, about 15 songs when we went in the studio.
Now, as your career has progressed, has the kind of material that you look for changed? Do you look for different kinds of songs than you did 10, 15, 20 years ago?
You know, I probably use the same formula that I always have. It's those songs that touch my heart. Those are the songs that I listen to and that I gravitate toward. And those are the ones I want to sing, because if I can sing a song that touches my heart, hopefully when I sing it, it touches your heart.
The next song up is Consider Me Gone. What can you tell us about it?
It's about this woman who is a confrontational woman. This lady, boy, she takes the bull by the horns and she says, look, we got a problem here. And he's still not paying any attention. So she said, if I'm not the one thing you can't stand to lose, consider me gone. I'm out of here.
Well, let's give it a listen. Reba McEntire is our guest here on the SiriusXM Artist Confidential Series. Consider Me Gone.
Something deeper than the weather, I can feel you all but shutting down. And when I need an explanation for the silence, you just tell me you don't wanna talk about it now. What you're not saying is coming in loud and clear.